Jean Kilbourn, a renowned activist, writer, and speaker, was born on January the 4th, 1943, in Junction City, Kansas. She received her bachelor's degree from Wesley College in 1964 and her master's in education from Boston University in 1972, followed by her doctorate in 1980. Throughout her career, she has been recognized for her work on the image of women in advertising and her critical studies of alcohol, tobacco in advertising. Jean Kilbourn's work is pioneering and crucial to the dialogue on one of the most unexplored yet most powerful realms of American culture, advertising. We owe her a great debt, Susan Faludi. Jean Kilbourn is most prominently known for her films, lectures, and writings. Her claim to fame was the film title Killing Us Softly, which was released in 1979. The second installment of the Killing Us Softly series, Still Killing Us Softly, was released in 1987. Since then, Jean Kilbourn has released two additional films in the series. These films identify and speak to major issues concerning the images of women in advertising and how these images have impacted our society. Ads sell more than products. They sell values, they sell images. They sell concepts of love and sexuality, of success, and perhaps most important, of normalcy. To a great extent, they tell us who we are and who we should be. In addition to her work on the objectification of women, Kilbourn has also known substantial work to call out concerns connected to the advertisement of alcohol, tobacco, and their impact on our society. Throughout her career, she has given innumerable amounts of lectures and presentations at universities, conferences, and seminars across the nation. She has produced several documentaries, films surrounding tobacco and alcohol, including Pack of Lies, Deadly Persuasion, and Spin the Bottle. The tobacco industry in the United States alone spends over $9 billion in advertising. The alcohol industry spends $3 billion a year in advertising. These industries often target children because when you hook them early, they are yours for life. The work that Jean Kilbourn has done is incredibly important to the media industry. The media is constantly promoting destructive patterns such as alcohol use, smoking, and sexism, which can contribute to physical and mental, emotional health issues. Jean Kilbourn's work relates to many personal convictions and interests. First and foremost, because I am a woman, women are not being appreciated and honored in a way that is respectful and considerate. They are being used as pawns to manipulate an audience of people who are thoughtless and who are not being taught to think about what's really happening within the images that we see in the media. Jean Kilbourn's work challenges me to ask myself, what are some of the batons that I want to pick up as I pursue communications? What messages do I want to share? What messages are being sent to our daughters? She challenges me to view these issues with a different lens. We were first introduced to Jean Kilbourn in Unit 4 on culture. This unit focused on how mass media shapes and influences culture. There is a major connection between culture and media. Unit 4 also focused on gender, how it gives us directives on femininity and masculinity. I believe that some of Jean Kilsbourne's most prolific work and main idea is surrounding the media's portrayal of women and how they are objectified and dehumanized. Advertising surrounds us with the idea of ideal female beauty. This ideal is based on absolute flawlessness. It cannot be achieved. Women's bodies constantly turned into things, into objects, says Kilbourne. These advertisements create a climate where there's widespread violence against women. Girls are encouraged at a young age to be impossibly beautiful. This leads to an epidemic of issues such as eating disorders. In Killing Us Softly 4, Jean Kilbourne stated, "Sometimes people say to me, 'You've been talking about this for 40 years. Have things gotten any better?' And actually, I have to say, really, they've gotten worse. People's desire and the way that we view media and advertisings are still the same. People are still being pulled by the wrong influences. I wonder, to what degree has Jean Kilbourne's message spread? Is there enough being done to solve this? The awareness of the issue has spread, but are we aware enough of the fact that things need to change? Unfortunately, not much has changed."